Welcome to Think Big with Dan and Qasim. Join host Dan Melnick and Qasim Masood as they explore big ideas, limitless possibilities, and engage with visionaries, entrepreneurs, and thought leaders who dare to dream big, get inspired, motivated, and find practical tips for personal growth. Think big, dream bigger, and ignite your potential.
All right, welcome to Think Big with Dan and Qasim. And if you want to go ahead and introduce yourself, tell us where you live and what you do for a living.
Hi, I'm Tanja. I'm the founder of Breadista, and I'm from LA right now. But I moved in 2018 from Germany to California. And yeah, since then, I try to get my head around some new adventures and started Breadista based on my German bread culture.
Awesome. So I guess if you can just tell me more about what it's, you know, what the company's about and really just how you got the idea for it.
Basically, it's pretty simple. As a German, you are crazy about bread, right? So a good bread in Germany or Western Europe, especially, it's, yeah, no way without it. So in the States, it still is and was 5 years ago, even more finding a good one. A good loaf of bread is, yeah, a very, very hard thing to do and find. And it's far away from the kind of bread we are used to, the quality, the variations. So back home, we have over 3,000 types of bread, not just white, brown, rye, or multigrain. And yeah, I missed it. Terribly. So I started to recreate my the hometown recipes. And yeah, that's actually the root of the whole thing. A lot of people tried it. Yes.
Yeah, so essentially that you like solved a problem for yourself, right? That you moved to America, you're like, the bread here sucks. Let me make better bread for myself. And then you're like, let me share it with everybody else.
Yeah, right. You can say that in short, yes.
Awesome. So I guess like as of now, like where can people find the bread? Do you mostly sell like in retail? Is it direct to consumer? Like how do you typically sell the bread?
Currently it's still D2C online in the own web shop. In the beginning, retail was actually a goal, of course, in big names like the natural grocery stores. And especially here on the California West Coast side, it feels people are more health conscious. They are more interested what is in the food they are putting in their bodies. So retail was a goal, but right now I moved it back on the list or pretty to the bottom. I think online is right now the way to go. I need to grow that more before I go the step into the retail business.
Well, I was curious, really. So like when you say online, is it more like people buying directly from your website or from Amazon? Like, what does that look like?
Only over the own web shop, our prettystar.world. Yes, it's the only place right now. I'm actually on the wholesale platforms Fair and Meet Maple for some small specialty retailer who found me online, Instagram, and asked about that. So I opened there some accounts just for the smaller retailers. It's a good thing. So you can try which area in the US is also in a mindset of a good bread. And it's funny to see it's coastal and Texas, actually. So it's funny to see in which areas the smaller retailers are interested in different bread, different new products, because the product itself, it seems or sounds maybe easy, pretty standard, but Americans are not used to have a good loaf of bread based on a bread mix. They think a boxed baking mix is for muffins, for brownies, a quick bread like cornbread or so, and that's it. But actually, I developed the products to have a real bakery quality bread, but it's actually made from a baking mix.
So essentially that you're in this platform where they like help you get into smaller retailers. Is that correct?
Yes.
Okay. So small retailers, like somebody has like one location, like a one-off, maybe like an ethnic market or something, like a European market or something like that.
Yeah, or I don't want to say gift shops, but some urban style shops who likes to showcase smaller brands, handcrafted products from Washington State. I have some there, or at the East Coast as well. Yeah, it's actually really, well, cheese stores, for example, summer cheese stores, because it's a great pairing, right? So yeah, it's actually pretty wide road on the smaller side of the retailers. But yes, right. Just one, two locations, maybe three. Yeah.
For sure. So I guess like in terms of selling on your website, is it more like, are you running ads? Like how do you get in front of new customers for the business?
Yeah, that's actually the tricky part. That's the tricky part, because when you're a really bootstrap business, it's hard to go a road where others prefer with, I don't know how many thousand dollars on ad spend. And yeah, it's word of mouth, social media, of course, own emails. Yeah, different kind, joining other brands, doing things together. Right now we are planning going into a subscription box for cheese. They came to me and asked for that. So it's a pretty good partnership for many boxes. And you have a new audience willing to try stuff at home, because they are already food interested in high quality food. So yeah, that's more the way to go. Or also locally, meeting some founders here in LA, meeting with them and try to find common ground, doing events together, bigger markets. Yeah, growing locally first, I would say, and then go wider.
For sure. So you go to like a market or like a weekend kind of market, and people are there, you know, sampling and trying different foods, and then you're there as well. And that's kind of how you've been able to, I guess, in a more cost-effective way, reach new customers, like, as opposed to running ads, which, like, as you mentioned, right, there's some level of uncertainty and like lots of budget and you're bootstrapped. So there's a challenge of like, how do you really scale and get in front of people in that kind of way?
And on the other hand, you need what I learned over the years now, a lot of education on this topic, because Americans are not used to real artisan bread, the craftsmanship of a baker. They are used to go to the store, grab a package from the shelf, and that's it. They are happy, right? But in Europe, it's more bread is a lifestyle. It's always on trend. And you can, the bread back home is so good. You can eat it just alone, the bread, maybe just leathered with butter. But here it feels for me a lot more like it's a carrier of your food, not the bread is the food. And with all the store-bought products, it's often you buy at the same time a lot of additives, chemical stuff. So you can say you are actually buying your future health problems in rates with each package. So the American is not used to have a good stuff on the shelf. It sounds maybe bad or weird, but that's what Europeans feel when they come over and see such packages on the shelf and you turn it around and actually read the label.
No, understood. So I guess like...
So you need a lot of education.
Yeah, for sure. Well, I guess I'm curious, really, like how do you educate and I guess convince somebody here in the U.S., right, that the current way... or the current bread that they're buying and eating is not as good as the one that you're selling. Like, how do you get them to make them understand that problem that they're having of like really being used to this like lower quality product?
Yeah, that's not easy. That's for sure. And that's a big thing. My big headline for this year is actually bringing this kind of education more upfront of the brand and everywhere on social media, going more into the education, showing why, of course, with videos in all the email sequences and so explaining. And luckily also I have customers, they are writing me back some feedback. They were in Europe, business trip, vacation, and so when they could eat everything over there without having health issues, stomach aches, bloating, and so on, right? They are coming back to the US trying to eat the same stuff, but then that happens on the issues are coming up again. So they actually feel when they try the better stuff, they can eat bread again. So bread is not that evil. The industry here in the US tries to tell you it is, because it's not the bread itself. So all the other ingredients in it, right? So I try with more videos, more e-guides, more newsletter content. It's a long way. It's a long road. But yeah, it's a steady drop, you know, you need that. So yeah.
For sure. So I guess like as of now, right? So you started this company back in 2018, or when did you officially launch the company?
The idea there was around fall 19. And I put everything together and started February 29th, actually, specifically that date.
Okay.
2020, yes.
Okay.
And so the first birthday is coming up in a couple
awesome.
of days.
So have you guys grown like year over year? I guess like what does growth look like for you?
Kind of, when I say, be honest, kind of wonky, because 2020, I just started right before everything closed because of the pandemic. And starting in summer that year, everything went crazy. Right? So the second half of 2020 was over the moon. It was like, oh my God, what's happening here?
Right, right.
But 21 was kind of similar, but you could feel that there's a difference. It was a little bit, not, I don't want to say slowed down, but the spring was different than summer. Summer better even than fall, and then holiday season came back. 22 was even more different, and 23 was totally different. So I'm not sure if you can say there is a certain type or way of growth. When you started in 2020, everything was different. So actually, right. in 2022, a lot of twos, is it was a step back, actually, and I have to refigure and tweak here and there to find a new way, because everyone started going back in the office work. There was less online purchases. You could feel that there is a change. So you have to adapt along the way and adjust everything.
For sure. But I guess like for 2024, right? Like how much are you looking to grow? Like even like by percentage, like how much, like for 2024 to be successful in your mind, like what would that look like from last year to this year?
Double this thing.
Double?
I would say, yes.
Awesome. 100% growth. Awesome.
Yeah. Need to be.
Awesome. So in terms of like right now, right, like you mentioned this subscription box that you're getting into, but I guess like besides that, like, you know, and some of the education, like what are some like your top priorities in the next few months for the business?
I would say networking, partnerships. That I think that's the way to go right now, finding similar brands, or I don't want to say similar, kind of the mixes. So similar in the overall topic with a better for you product who is a good match. So it could be, yeah, from cheese to a spread to breakfast things, you know, just, yeah, networking and kind of the way learning from maybe a brand just some steps ahead of you, of us, of Breadista. And on the other hand, networking, partnering with brands to grow together, find ways, similarities. I think together you are stronger than every part alone, especially today when you have to go against some big names, or it's hard to be loud out there without big budgets or a famous name behind you, or yeah, something like that.
For sure. So obviously now in 2024 that many companies are looking for the best use case for high level technology like AI. So do you guys use AI in your business? And if not, like where could AI may come in and help you guys out?
Personally, I'm a little bit hesitant with the AI. So you can say I'm a bit old school, probably. I tried it once with some content text, but I have always to tweak everything content-wise. So I'm not sure if I would use it for content, probably right. For some stuff in the background. to gain some more or deeper knowledge of customer experience, or to understand more the purchase process of some persons or audiences. And I think then more somewhere in the back end, not actually packaging design or video or content text or so.
Yeah, maybe like a chat where it can explain more, because you are selling sort of a new category of products here in the US. So you probably have lots of customers who might have questions about it, about the ingredients, like how to make it, how it's made, things like that.
Right. Yeah, absolutely.
Awesome. So what would you say is like the one biggest piece of advice that you wish you knew before you started this company?
Oh, that's a good one. I would say, as an immigrant, you may think you know kind of or a piece of America and the market, but it's totally different. When you're coming from a foreign country with a foreign mindset and a foreign level of quality of food, it's kind of shocking when you're going deeper into the topic and when you're talking to the people. And it seems easy when you think, hey, I have such a good product. It's so good back home in Europe. And you think that's it for America, right? But then it's, oh no. So you need a lot of knowledge upfront. Yes, of course, you could have made more research, right? But I'm more the girl who is learning by doing along the way. It just as it comes. And that's my whole life. So
for sure. So if we're going to have this conversation again in 1 year from now, where do you see things going for the business?
Besides double the revenue, having much more brand awareness out there, hoping to have probably one or two retail doors here locally from the biggest natural grocery stores here. But and have a lot of network contacts, I hope so, to gain more insights of food overall and the retail stuff. And I always curious to hear other stories from founders and what I can learn from them, and how I can help the next one in line behind me just starting out. So
I mean, it's definitely not easy. And I mean, it's we're definitely rooting for you and hoping for lots of success in 2024. So if somebody watching this wanted to reach out to you, do you mind sharing your website or social media? I guess best ways to get in contact.
Website is breadista.world, and that's the same handle on Facebook and Instagram. And of course, I'm also on LinkedIn. That's the reason I love LinkedIn and networking over there. So that was our way, right?
Exactly how we connected.
Yeah,
exactly. Awesome. Well, I just want to say thank you so much for your time today.
Thank you, Dan, having me on here.
Of course, anytime. Thanks. All right. Bye.
Bye.